Daniel Mihigo off the pitch here. Daniel Mihigo is him. I'm Charles Motevi, but this is off the pitch. Anyhow, Daniel, we talked about your education before the show started. You did project planning at UCU for your undergraduate. Now you're doing a postgraduate diploma at Ndeje University. And if you have the time, you'll pursue the master's after the 1 year. You said growing up, you knew you wanted to play badminton. So sometimes your education will take a back seat. But you graduated at UCU. How do you look at education now? Because obviously it would be better if you could concentrate on one. Is that how you feel, or you don't mind doing the two of them?
Actually, I feel it is better that I have both. Maybe if I was concentrating on one, I would at a point lose concentration. But one helps me to concentrate on both. Actually, they interchangeably help me concentrate. Because when I'm in school, I'm resting from the workouts and stuff, so my body's recovering. And then when I'm training, I'm resting my mind from the books. They say work without play makes... Losing on court, okay, it has an effect, of course, but here in Uganda, most of the times I'm winning. So the times I've lost are less than the times I've won. So it doesn't really affected me. Though it does, but you know, everything has an effect on you unless you know how to handle the thing. Yeah, so I've learned ways how to handle my losses and try to still concentrate on something else.
I kind of understand what you're saying, because sometimes the problem with sportsmen is having too much time on their hands, especially when they are famous and maybe getting some money. Sometimes having too much time, especially if they're young and lack the sense of self-discipline, it can have a negative effect on them. You're saying the fact that you have to handle two things doesn't leave so much idle time for you. That's good. Because how about the argument, though, that having to do one thing would help you specialize and therefore help you succeed? Because when you go out to play against the better players, are they also in the same system? Are they also going to school and at the same time playing badminton? I'm talking about tournaments that are not like university tournaments.
Some people are better when they're concentrating on one thing at the same time. Other people do best when they have a lot to do. Yeah, some people do best under pressure. And some people do best when they're concentrating on one thing. So me personally, I think I perform better when I have too much pressure. Yeah, so when I have the pressure, then I can make sure I do my best. Yeah, so it doesn't affect me really. Yeah.
A sucker for pressure, Daniel Mihigo. What is the plan for your education? Do you consider it as like a soft landing when your education ends, or is it something very serious in your mind?
Education, without education in the world of today, you're nothing, no matter how rich you are, no matter how great you are at sports. Without your education, you are undermined. But education will help you to, first of all, know different other aspects of life, which you can't learn from only sports. And then education is also another option. If you're not earning from your sport, then you can earn from your education. Because sports has a limit. There will come a time where I'll have to retire, or as a person, sports person, you'll be done with your sports and you can no longer earn from it. So education will help you now earn instead of your sport.
The friends you grew up with, did they consider it an education or sports? How many of them have been able to balance the two like you?
Some tried to concentrate on only the sport, ended up getting injuries and they quit, and now they can't do anything for themselves. Others concentrated on the sport alone and they're doing great. Like for example, some footballers I know, they're doing so well in football and they're earning a lot from the football because they concentrated on only the football. Then others who did some of them left the sports and concentrated on only books. Some are now having great jobs and yeah. But I would say, like I told you, it depends on the personality. Yeah.
I first played Dan in my in my primary five, and that was under 15, where it was a tight match because he's a good player and he managed to beat me. But I played him again in under 19, main singles, and until I joined him where he was at UCU. So he became my teammate. So me, I just joined UCU recently. Yeah, so he graduated me. I'm still a student at UCU.
Different people have different paths, and for you this path has been fruitful. Why are you not sure about the master's?
I decided to do my postgraduate diploma, which is shorter than a master's, because sometimes we do things without planning. So I was like, I have other plans, so education must be there, but I need to do something. Like, for example, I wasn't sure of completing the master's, which is for a two-year course. But the diploma, I can do it in 1 year. Maybe as I'm applying for different jobs, I'll get a job, and the job will require me to have more time into the... But I cannot give up on my sport, so I have room for my sport. But if I have a job, my sport plus education, that will be too much on my plate now. So that's the reason I decided to take up my postgraduate diploma and not the master's.
But you really attend class, because I have a sneaky feeling that playing badminton is 50% of your work, and all you need is 50% is to pass. Is that the case, or do you actually have to be in class and they set targets for you and you have to sit exams like the rest of, like the normal us who can't be on court and do special things?
I actually do sit exams, I do attend classes, and actually the last time I attended class was Saturday. I had an exam on Saturday, yeah, so I attend class.
How did the exam go?
I can't tell how it went right now. The results are not yet out, but I felt I did good, yeah.
When I was in an exam and I couldn't tell how it went, I knew it didn't go so well. I hope it hasn't happened for you that way.
If it is for books, well, if you're able to cater for your tuition and stuff and all that, if that is, it's a personal choice. But I personally would advise you to take up both and give it 100%. In whatever you do, make sure you're giving it your all. And give each its own time. Do not try to do badminton or the sport at the time of books. You should have time for the sport and time for education. Yeah.
What would you say about the universities like UCU and DJ, who have taken it upon themselves to, so to speak, fill the gap that maybe can't be taken over by federations? In terms of promoting sport, a word to the universities like UCU and Ndeja, and even in some cases maybe Makere.
First of all, I would like to say thanks to UCU, for it has really helped us as athletes and mostly student athletes. You know, it's not easy to study while doing sports. Yeah, it's challenging, like I told you. But they managed to help you out. For instance, when we travel for events, there is a way we are able to catch up. They help us. They help us in case we miss like tests. We are given other tests. But obviously, we are not cheated for, because that's the mentality of most people. They think as athletes, we do not have to sit.
They mark your exams with one eye.
No. Actually, it's funny, but most lecturers do not even know you as sportsmen in class. They do not know you, and they do not want to know you. So they treat everybody fairly and equally. So yeah, the universities really help. Yeah, and then Ndeje University is actually the best sports university in Uganda. It has really done a great job in promoting sports. They educate sportsmen, they feed them, they accommodate them. So they've really done a great job in promoting sports, which federations have failed to do.
How do your friends, the friends you grew up with, how do they feel about your travels? I mean, the fact that you can travel. I know it may not be a big deal to some people, but I'm sure, how was your first flight like?
My first flight was actually a very big deal to me, though it was way back when I was in my senior one, 2008. That was my first flight. I actually went, that's the first time I even traveled out of Africa. I went to Poland, and I would say it wasn't because of my current sport. That was in baseball. I represented the national junior team in World Baseball Championships in Poland in 2008, and that was my very first flight. But it was like a dream come true. Yeah, I never thought I would board a plane, but I did it, yeah. And yeah.
Incredible. Baseball, basketball. You said you started with baseball, basketball, and
badminton.
And badminton.
And football. And football.
Yeah. Was badminton the sport you could play the most of those three?
Of the three, badminton was the sport that my school acknowledged. And it was the sport that had less body contact. You know, whenever I played baseball, I would go back home with injuries. My mom is like, where are you from? You know, African parents, they beat you up. You're bleeding, but they still beat you up.
Thank you, mama.
Yeah, they tell you, I didn't want you to do that. Now you see what's happening. Yeah, it was because I understand, because they were caring. Yeah, because they didn't want me to get injured. And yeah, and then badminton, all the schools I went to had badminton. And all my friends loved the sport. So that's how I came about to concentrate on badminton.
And but,
it started paying my tuition, my fees, so I had to stick to it.
Wise decision. When we come back, we're going to ask Daniel about the future. Stay on off the pitch.